Also, the people find difficult to go nearby the dustbin and open the lid of the dustbin, which eventually make them to throw the trash nearby the bins. So on the other hand, the smart dustbin enhance the proper waste management system, and also it lowers the human labors. And as a citizen, it is our duty to keep the city clean. So we have come up with one of the main concerns with our environment, that has been the solid waste management, which impacts both the health and environment of our society. Now we shall discuss the proposed system of design and implementation of smart waste management system. Here, the system will detect the trash in the dustbin and will also monitor the level of the garbage at the dustbin, which will help to notify the admin or the cleaner about the present status of the garbage bin by using GSM module. And the system will also detect a person approaching the dustbin with a trash so that it can automatically open the lid. And the management of the waste in its proper manner is very time efficient, and it make the environment clean. So our next topic is about the components used in the project that will further proceed by Mousumi Kalita.
We have used the components servo motor, electro ultrasonic sensor, Arduino Uno, and GSM module. The next slide. Okay, so first I'm going to explain about servo motor. A servo motor is an electronic device which can push or rotate an object with great precision. So before that, I'd like to say that servo motor basically of two types, rotatory actuator and another one is linear actuator. Rotatory actuator rotate the shaft at the fixed angle, and linear actuator helps in fixed linear movement. So a servo motor can be AC or DC. Servo motor basically have four parts: motor, reduction gearbox, encoder or potentiometer, and a control circuit. Through microcontroller, we have to give a signal to the control circuit, which is in the form of PWM, that stands for pulse width modulation. Control circuit decode the PWM signal and decide through how much angle we have to rotate the motor. As the motor is connected to the control circuit, the motor rotates in clockwise or in anti-clockwise direction, according to which output shaft also rotate, and the encoder connected to this shaft gives the feedback signal to the control circuit. When the control circuit receives the feedback signal, this will get to know that after re receiving that specified angle, predetermined angle, control circuit stop the motor on the basis of the signal received by the encoder or the potentiometer. The next slide. Yes, so the next component is ultrasonic sensor. We have used here the H3SR04 ultrasonic sensor. This sensor has 4-pin module. Okay, so before going to proceed further, I would like to give a brief description about this ultrasonic sensor. These are the sensor used for use ultrasonic wave to detect object and auto measure the distance between the object and the sensor itself. We have used two ultrasonic sensors in our whole project, one for the lid opening by measuring the distance of the distance between the object and the sensor, and another one inside the lid for the measurement of the waste level. So that after reaching a pre-specified value, GSM module, which we have also used in this project, can give the information to the authority. Sensor, this reflected wave is observed by the ultrasonic receiver module. to measure the distance between the object and the sensor, we use this simple formula, distance equal to speed into time. We know the ultrasonic wave has a universal speed, which is 330 meter per second. Hello, sir, am I audible? Sir, am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Okay, sir, thank you, sir. Okay, so now calculate. On the circuit inbuilt on the module will calculate the time taken for the ultrasonic wave to come back and turn on the echo pin high for that same particular amount of time. So I have mentioned the echo pin here. So we have basically four pins in an ultrasonic sensor, VCC. This pin powers the sensor typically with 5 volt, and the second pin is trigger pin, third is echo pin, and fourth one is ground. So next slide. Thank you, sir. So Arduino Uno, which is the which we can say the headquarter of our whole project, it's an open source electronics platform based on easy to use hardware and software. In our project, it can be called as the headquarter of the whole project. The boards are equipped with sets of digital and analog input output pins that may be interfaced to the various expansion boards and breadboards. So Arduino Uno, we have 14 digital pins. Here, the other components we have used, like a servo motor, US, we have connected these 14 digital pins. Out of those 14 digital pins, we have six PWM output pins. And we have in Arduino Uno, six analog input pins, a USB connection, and a power jack. We have power pins 3.3 volt, 5 volt, and ground, which supply the power to the input-output components. Power jack is to give the power to the Arduino. USB port to upload the program to the Arduino, and reset pin to reset the whole program. Okay, thank you, sir. Next slide will be proceeded by Janav Berman.
Thank you, Mosumi. GSM module. One of the most essential element of IoT project is ability to connect device. Wi-Fi and Bluetooth are good and low cost choice, but they work only at the close range. When the device needs to be at a remote location, GSM is a good and easy setup device. In our project, we use SIM900 GSM module. To send and receiving SMS, we use ATI command. GSM module is used ATI command, which is easiest way to communicate with GSM. ATI mean attention command, which use simple word. ATI command is used to instruct GSM to do different tasks. Insert SIM in SIM tray, connect the antenna to pointing outward the GSM module. Connect the ground of the GSM module to the ground of the Arduino. TX of the GSM module pin is connected with the Arduino digital pin. And RX pin of the GSM module is connected with the Arduino digital pin. A GSM module needs external power, which is 12 volt, 2 ampere power adapter. In our project, we use SIM900 GSM module, in where AMR926ES processor is used, which is used for phone and data communications. Sir, next slide. Architecture. System architecture. First, we considered the left-hand side. When person come in front of the dustbin, then the dustbin which is fitted in front of the dustbin, the data will send to the Arduino. After getting the data, Arduino instruct the servo motor to rotate 45 degrees and the lid is open. Again, when the person is going away from the dustbin, the sensor again sends the data to Arduino, and Arduino instructs some servo motor to rotate minus 45 degrees. Then the lid will be closed. And in this way, cycle is proceed. In the other hand, Second, ultrasonic sensor sense, which is fitted with the upper portion of the lid towards depth of the dustbin. When the level of the waste is cross the limit which set on the ultrasonic sensor through Arduino, then the sensor send data to Arduino. After getting the data, Arduino instruct the GSM module to send notification through SMS to the admin. Then admin collect the waste from dustbin. So next slide. Here we connect our circuit first part, which I already told that there one Arduino is present, an ultrasonic sensor and a servo motor, which is connected. Plus 5 volt is connected with the 5 volt of Arduino, and ground pin is ultrasonic sensor ground pin is connected with Arduino ground pin. And trigger point of ultrasonic sensor is connected with 11 number digital pin, and the echo point is connected with the 10 number digital pin. And also the servo motor connected with for power purpose, one pin is connected with ground and another pin is connected with 5 volt. And the data transfer, for data transfer we connected the digital pin in 9. So next slide. Here we connect GSM module with Arduino and ultrasonic sensor. The ultrasonic sensor plus 5 volt is connected with the plus 5 volt of Arduino, and the ground pin is in the same way connected with the ground, and the GSM module the TX and RX pin is connected with 2 and 3 port, which I already mentioned in the program. Thank you, sir. Next slide will be explained by Rashmi Basmati.
So, working principle. The proposed smart waste management system consists of Arduino Uno, servo motor, ultrasonic sensor, and GSM module. A program is installed in Proteus, which enables the ultrasonic sensor to sense the distance of the garbage from the lid. As the garbage is thrown into the bin, when the threshold level is reached, according to the level assigned by the user, the ultrasonic sensor will inform the Arduino about the dustbin that is filled up to its maximum limit. Then the Arduino will instruct the GSM module to send a notification in the form of a message or SMS to the admin's department person, and thus update the status of the bin. The system leads to the unloading of waste, making the whole process time efficient and hygienic. Now, the working principle can be more properly understood by the flowchart. So, sir, next slide. So, in the flowchart, we can see that when the system starts, it firstly checks the dustbin garbage level, whether it reaches threshold level set by the user. Now, if the garbage reaches the threshold level, the system will send a notification to the admin by using GSM module. And if the garbage do not reaches the threshold level, then the system will wait for the user instruction. On the other hand, we can see in the left-hand side, if the dustbin is not full. Now, if the dustbin is not full, the system will detect the person and open the lid of the dustbin, and automatically it will close when the person will move away from the dustbin. As we can see in the left side, else the lid remains closed. So if the person is away from the dustbin, then the dustbin will automatically close. So next slide. Advantages of smart dustbin: keeps the environment clean and fresh. It keeps our surroundings green and free from bad odor of waste, emphasizing on healthy environment and keep cities more beautiful. It reduces environment pollution as smart transport vehicles go only on the filled containers or bins. So it will decrease the traffic flow and consequently noises due to less air pollution and as a result of less waste collection vehicles on road. This practice is highly lucrative. Now, the smart waste management, it will reduce the manpower requirement to handle the garbage collection process. Save fuel and time using appropriate route planning. As smart transport vehicles go only to the filled containers or bins, it also reduces the infrastructure operating and maintenance costs. Now, as the GSM module will send the SMS to the admin so the team can clear the bins in due time. Stop overflowing of dustbins. Applying smart waste management, it will optimize management resources and costs and making it a smart city. So next slide. Limitations of the smart waste management. The process is not always cost effective. As the system requires more number of waste bins for separate waste collection, and this results into high initial cost. So the practice are not done uniformly. Garbage segregation is very difficult. With cities getting more and more crowded by each passing minute, it is becoming difficult for authorities to manage the huge amount of waste that keeps accumulating every day. So next slide. So now we'll go on to the applications of smart waste management. Real-time based cleaning at hospitals, near market areas and near residential areas. A major problem with our present society is the solid waste management, as it disturbs both the human health and affects the environment. So in the hospital, the waste may cause risk of infection, for example, bandages, dresses, etc. So the smart dustbins in the hospital will prevent lumping of garbage, which ends up giving foul smells causes illness to the people. Most of the urban cities and towns in India are not well designed to facilitate the proper garbage disposing and collection mechanism. Also, there are cities which are expanding rapidly and putting the pressure on current infrastructure. So smart waste bins can be used in areas where there is no proper waste disposal method, including areas close to a waste dump and where water supply has become more contaminated, either due to waste dumping or leakage from landfill sites. So
the project and the design that we have developed, it consists of the components, that is Arduino Uno, ultrasonic sensor, servo motor, and GSM module. The first and very important thing is we use two ultrasonic sensors. That is, the first ultrasonic sensor is used to sense the distance of the person who comes to throw the waste in the dustbin. Whenever a distance which is assigned to the ultrasonic sensor, with that distance, the ultrasonic sensor instructs the Arduino about the receiving all of the ultrasonic waves, and the Arduino Uno, it instructs the servo motor for the opening of the lid. Whenever the person is away from the ultrasonic sensor or the dustbin, the ultrasonic sensor is actually located on the outside of the dustbin so that it can measure the distance between the person who is coming to throw the trash into the garbage. And so whenever there is no person, the lid
remains closed. Apart from that, the second ultrasonic sensor, there is another ultrasonic sensor which is located on the above of the leaf, which determines the level or measures the distance between the trash level, whether it is filled or not, the maximum limit which has been assigned. And if it is filled, then it instructs the Arduino about it, which further instructs the GSM module. And the GSM module sends an SMS to the concerned department person, who is the admin, and that is, who is concerned in taking the trash out of that garbage. So that is what is written in the slide. That is the smart dustbin management uses Arduino Uno, ultrasonic sensor, servo motor, and GSM module. The lid of the dustbin stays closed so that the waste is not exposed. When any waste is needed to be disposed, an ultrasonic sensor will sense it from a particular distance, and it will automatically open the lid. In this point, we are talking about the first ultrasonic sensor, which is fitted in the outside of the dustbin. And in the next point, we have another ultrasonic sensor, which is used, which enables to sense the distance of the garbage from the lid. As garbage is thrown into the bin, when the threshold level is reached, that is the level which is assigned, that is reached according to the level assigned, the ultrasonic sensor, it informs the Arduino about the dustbin, filling up to its maximum limit. So can I have the next slide, please? Thank you, sir. Whenever, and this slide consists of the GSM module, which sends notification to the admin department person, the concerned person who is responsible to come and pick up the waste from that, from the dustbin. And this leads to time efficiency. This saves fuel as well as it saves time. That's what is written in this point, that on reaching its maximum limit, GSM module sends a notification in the form of a message or SMS to the admin department person, and thus update the status of the bin. Thus, the system is able to monitor the level of the dustbin through the communication process encouraged by the GSM technology. This is the figure number 9. It is just the prototype of the smart dustbin that we have prepared. So can I have the next slide? Thank you, sir. Then finally, we come to the conclusion of our project. The very first thing that we conclude, that this has a proper time management system and it has a proper planning, because one did not, the concerned person who is in charge of taking the dustbin and the wastes out of the bin should not just go and check it out very often or frequently, the whether the dustbin is full or not. It happens sometimes that they have to come and they have to see that, oh, it is half filled, and they have to take the half fill and dispose it off somewhere. But after implementing this design, there is a proper notification which goes to the concerned person, so that they could know that the dustbin is full and they can come back there and dispose it off only when it is needed. So finally, it saves, in that way it saves fuel, it saves time, it saves labor, and it is time efficient. Along with it, it is environment friendly, so it reduces pollution too. That's what is written in the slide. That is, the proposed smart waste management system consists of servo motor, ultrasonic sensor, and Arduino Uno interface with GSM module. The system gives a real-time indicator of the garbage level in a smart bin at any given time through SMS or GSM module. This system helps in monitoring of domestic waste clearance at proper time, which do not affect the public health.